Apart from the power related issue, the depletion in yield of a well could have an impact on the crop productivity. So has that been looked at? Let's say even though I have unlimited source of energy, but let's say for example, even though they could not fix the energy problem, the crop productivity could be under stress. So are there any interesting examples of someone looked at it? And
I mean, I'm sure you mentioned evident everywhere. So we were doing this study on energy irrigation nexus in Punjab and Karnataka. In Punjab, you know, you can kind of chase falling water levels. You can replace a 5 horsepower pump by a 15 horsepower pump, and you can maintain the yield of your well. In Karnataka, it's just not possible. I mean, beyond a stage, there's no point in going deeper. So it also has implications in terms of how you ration power supply. In Karnataka, the demand is for daily power ration in 3 or 4 installments. So you have 2 hours of power in the morning, so that the well has enough time to kind of get some water. Same in Hard Rock, Saurashtra, where power rations are. So I think the point that you're making is kind of very valid. There must be a number of different examples. So everybody is trying to kind of optimize. Farmers are trying to optimize their wells, and they're trying to get the power ration such that they can get most out of their wells. Still, in Karnataka, we also found that most large and middle farmers, they had to keep large areas of the land fallow, because their wells just didn't have enough water to support irrigation.
So, I mean, in a sense, my question was that if we knew that this much water we have withdrawn, let's say, so in this area, was there any correlation to productivity? Though we knew that groundwater irrigation improved our food productivity for some years, the depletion had any clear quantum productivity issues?
I haven't studied. I would probably think so, but I haven't done any studies on that. I think that the more common thing would be for farmer to give adequate water ration to a smaller part of his field than to spread a limited amount of water over a much larger area.
In the Gangetic Plain of Bihar and Uttar Pradesh, for quantity of groundwater being exploited for drinking purpose and irrigation. The finding was there that for irrigation, almost 5 times more water is being utilized as compared to drinking. And arsenic is coming in drinking water due to over-exploitation of water for irrigation, not for drinking. And through irrigation water, arsenic has entered into the food chain also. In many crops, like we have studied rice, wheat growing in that area, that is being irrigated by groundwater. And if arsenic has entered into the food chain, it's increasing the disease burden of arsenic. So there are 2 implications of over-exploitation of groundwater in our area for the purpose of irrigation. Normally it was there that for drinking only the groundwater was being used. But nowadays, the rapid use of groundwater for even irrigation is reverse what we are seeing in Karnataka. And that is why the two related problems are coming. One, the occurrence of arsenic in the drinking water, and the entry of the arsenic in the food chain. So these things has to be through arsenic can be reduced.